The Chinese markets have, well, they haven't done well over the last few years, but we want to highlight how investors would invest in the Chinese markets. First, there's the Shanghai Stock Exchange, home to the A shares, they call it. It's available mostly to Chinese nationals. The Shanghai Composite is down nearly 66% since its all-time high back in 2007. Now, for foreigners, those outside of China, there's the China Enterprise Index. Chinese companies traded in Hong Kong are home to the H shares. Investors could buy this, international investors. The index, though, is down almost 53% since the high back in 2007. They're both relatively swim in the same sea. But the question is there an opportunity for the average investor possibly to benefit or make money from that downside over the past 7 years? For more on China's economy and the markets, we're joined by Jonathan Brodsky. He's the managing director with Advisory Research in Chicago. And Jonathan, welcome to the show. Let me just start with this. The markets have not been good. Why haven't investors been buying Chinese stocks over the past 7 years?
I think the lack of enthusiasm for Chinese securities really emanates probably more from the declining growth story in China rather than the fundamentals. You're not seeing an earnings declination nearly as much as you're seeing a negative sentiment, and that has impacted the stocks on the downside.
Wait, fair enough. I was talking to my producer earlier as we were preparing for the show, and we had this conversation that growth in China has been pretty good, 7, 8, 9% over the past 7 years. I mean, that's very good. A lot of countries would be jealous of that. But the stock market has performed the exact opposite. How do you explain that to people?
So we at Advisory Research, we're value investors. We're looking for quality companies trading at fair prices. And I think when people look at the overall decline in the market, you're going off a very high peak. So the relationship to the fundamentals of the companies have really come in line now relative to where they were in 2007. So the opportunity now is quite exciting from our perspective relative to market in 2007 and going into 2008, which was probably a bit frothy. As a result, we are indicating to our investors that we think this is a very interesting time to consider investing within the Chinese market.
Okay, I'm going to try to read between the lines. You say interesting. Does that mean you think it's a time to buy?
I think certain sectors are quite interesting. You mentioned housing stocks and banking stocks as being somewhat exposed to the property market. We would tend to agree with you on that. Other areas that really have seen the declination more meaningfully over the years and are beginning to improve profit margins would be along the lines of the consumer discretionary stocks, which have very strong balance sheets and are less exposed to what's going on within the financial market.
Okay. I'm going to ask an awfully dumb question because
you
clearly know this topic very well. But for our viewers who are watching, whether you're in London or New York or Hong Kong, and they say, look, I'm interested in Chinese stocks. I want to participate in Chinese stocks. I agree with you that I want to buy. How do they go about doing that?
Well, there's different ways to do it. Obviously, there are exchange-traded funds and index funds that proliferate in the U.S. market, in the Hong Kong market, in the London market. But we're strong believers in active stock picking. We believe that the opportunity to research names, especially in a market where there are lots of opportunities to work through, is particularly appealing. So I think as it relates to the Chinese market, given corporate governance concerns, given exposure to the government concerns, and other related concerns like that, there's really a great opportunity for active stock pickers, where ETFs and index funds tend to buy the broad market. Oftentimes, they're getting securities in there that perhaps you wouldn't be buying if you were able to analyze them on an individual basis.
China is unique, and you know this because a lot of the focus is on what the government says, what the government does, or what they don't do, and that's what investors think about pretty much all the time. Yep. The latest reports of urbanization, the plans, the reformings for banks, how should investors look at that? Is this a positive sign that we say, look, it's time to buy right now because of that?
I think the Chinese government is making excellent steps given the current situation within the economy. You see increased liberalization with the yuan peg, interest rate liberalization, and other forms, including anti-corruption campaign, as well as improvement within the environment. These are all very important steps, we think, for creating a structured and a balanced economy. And if you look historically at academic research, there really isn't much of a connection between GDP growth and stock market returns. There's a much closer connection to strong corporate governments, strong corporate governance, as well as strong government control over the market to improve long-term performance of securities.
Jonathan Brodsky, thank you for the advice. Managing Director of Advisory Research joining us from Chicago.